on. So I'm going to stop it right there. Thank you for your responses as far as what you saw for visual evidence in the video. Can you minimize that, Deshondra, and pull the PowerPoint back up? And go to the next slide after that one. Let's do it from current slide and then hit next. Great. Skip forward with that. First, go. Great. So now that we have an introduction to visual evidence, what we're going to be moving on from here is how to find sources that are reliable. All right, so we recapped our case. We got caught up to speed from what we missed last week. We refreshed our minds on what visual evidence means. Now we need to think more critically about evidence and how we know what evidence, what sources we can use to make our case for Joe and whether or not he should go to school again or not. Okay? So, first question, what does it mean to be reliable? Again, let me see your hand, and I'll take responses. Javelle.
To be able to be counted on.
Counted on, perfect. Anybody else? Reliable. What words come to mind for you? Elliot.
Trustworthy.
Trustworthy, cool. Any others? John.
Able to rely on
somebody. That's the literal definition. Reliable means being able to rely on somebody. Deshondra, can you hit the next button, please? So, that was interesting because in your definitions of reliable, trustworthy, able to rely on somebody, count on somebody, this seems all to relate to reliable people. So inherently, in your definition of reliable, it sounds like you think about reliable people first. Not just like a reliable chair. It's sturdy. It's not going to fall. A reliable boat, it's not going to sink, right?
That's what they said about the Titanic.
Exactly. So reliable is even bigger than just people who are trustworthy. It's something that's sturdy, all right? It's anything that you can trust to depend on what it's for, all right? Y'all already talked about reliable people. So let's see. Y'all ever play Family Feud?
Don't hit anybody yet.
So, survey says, these are my top three hits for reliable. Let's see if we hit any so far. Hit the first one, Deshondra. Trustworthy. Elliot got that one. All right, consistent and honest.
I didn't do this.
We missed consistent and honest. Yeah, I forgot to change them one by one, but we got all three. But we got trustworthy. So, I agree. Trustworthy, consistent, honest. These are things that we look for in reliable people. And we're going to think about our sources for our case because we want reliable sources as well. Can you go forward, Deshondra? Thank you. So, everybody take 10 seconds to just read through this question and some of the considerations I put up there so far. All right, so here's my question to you. Given the little bullet points I already put up here, I want you to tell me, how do we know whether something that we find online is a reliable source or not? Deshondra.
Because, like, you can tell, like, right here it says that the mother trustworthy ones.
Sorry, I couldn't hear you. Can you speak up more?
The ones right there, it say that those are the trustworthy ones because you know that they're not .com, so, like, anybody can't just go in there and edit them.
Okay, so let me clarify my question. The bullet points I put up right here are just ideas, right? I'm not saying that any government site is trustworthy or any nonprofit organization is trustworthy. The suggestion with these ideas is simply to keep in mind that what we're looking for, well, these are things that we can tell from our internet site. We can look at the domain name and what URL it's coming from. We can see if it has an author or if somebody owns a site. We can see what type of media it is. Is it a journal, a magazine, a newspaper? And we can also see things like how many thumbs up does it have? How many times has it been shared? Right? How many people have watched it or viewed it? These are all things that inform our decision as to whether or not it's a reliable source. So with that in mind, what else can we add? What things do you think are reliable sources if you're looking for information for homework? Put up your hand, let me know. John. What?
.edu.
So, do you have an example of when you went to a .edu site? No? That's fine. Deshondra?
Ford.
I didn't hear you.
Ford.
Org? So what does that mean?
A nonprofit organization.
Have you been to a .org site before?
Yes.
Do you remember which one was their last one?
I went there.
So John's just said pbs.org. Have y'all been on that site? Thumbs up if you've been on that site.
I have another one.
I'll come to you. Elliot, have you been to pbs.org?
No. Look, yeah, because I had to get my budget in.
Okay. So, those of you who have been to pbs.org, another question to consider. Why did you go there? And what made you think that was a reliable site? Hang on. Let me see your hand. Somebody have her from Marcus. All right. Anybody else? New voice? Zion? Have you been to PBS or? No. Why do you go there? You don't know? Javelle, you got an answer for him.
My cousin.
So, Javelle is saying his cousin asked to get on there. So, the site was referred to him by somebody else. Well, let's keep that in mind, because that's another way that we determine reliability for our sources, by who tells us about them. Beth, you had another comment you were going
to make? I went to timeforkids.org.
Time for Kids. That's a great site.
It's .org.
So again, why, Beth, do you trust Time for Kids?
Because one of my science teacher told me to go there, and because it has the latest news for kids.
Okay, so your science teacher told you to go?
Yeah.
That's a pretty good reason. I would trust my science teacher too. How about Wikipedia? That one's an interesting one. Do y'all ever use Wikipedia? Hang on.
I want to see
a hand. Let's see. Is there anything? I know you started saying no. What do you think about? Okay, anybody can put anything on it. But, I use Wikipedia. I know all of y'all get on Wikipedia sometimes. So what do we go there for?
Information.
Hang on, to show you?
Information.
Information, what kind of information? What do we have to think about when we go to Wikipedia?
Think about.
John.
Does it sound right?
What's it? What do you mean by sound right?
Like, if they say something stupid, you would, like, not, I mean...
No, I hear you, fine.
Okay, if they say something stupid, you could tell if it's not right.
Okay, so tone. How about we use that word? The tone, the grammar, how it's written, whether it has a bias or not. So yeah, anybody can edit Wikipedia, but Wikipedia also has citations and references and links to other journals, other sites that we know are trustworthy. All of Wikipedia isn't, but... We go there because the information that we can get is a nice starting point, okay? Let's keep moving forward because we're going to be...